My name is Eduardo Martinez. I was dead in February and March of 1970, and I was wounded as a D4. And my nickname in Vietnam with the company was Pancho. I was born in Mexico City. And when they told me to go into the army, I went into the army. And I thought that I wasn't gonna go to Vietnam. They sent me anyway. And there's so many people like me who were a citizen from Mexico and not many other countries that we serve, and we did our job. I didn't put no excuses. I was scared like everybody else, but I went through. I did my job. I'm very proud of my company, all the guys that serve with me, because, you know, they're an incredible bunch of guys. It's just amazing. They never say, oh, I didn't want to go. I didn't think it was right, the war. No, they all talk about the same thing. They did their job, they lived the experiences, and I'm very proud to have served. Going over there, you know, a lot of things come into your mind. You say, well, why me? I mean, I'm too young. I'm scared, you know. I'm not going to make it. What if they kill me? So you have to right then make a decision. Should I go or not? I thought about that. I thought about going AWOL, but at the end I decided, no. I have to do my job. And you know, you say, well, all these guys are here. Why should I be afraid? So it probably was about 1 o'clock in the morning. I got off the airplane and it was dark. Everything else was dark except the building where we were gonna go in. And you just wonder, oh, are they gonna shoot at us? Are they gonna attack us right now? You know, my first time in Vietnam, and I'm there already. There's no going back. I gotta do my job, I gotta continue. I got to see a little bit of it, of everything. My friend Bill Connell was sitting in front of me on the foxhole. He was reading a book, but I was just sitting there thinking. All of a sudden, something told me, look out. And there were these two guys running. So I told him, look. And Bill looked to his right to look outside, and he saw these guys, and he said, fire. And then he tried his grenade launcher, the M30, and it didn't work. And my sergeant was laying on the ground asleep. His rifle was loaded about 10 feet from him. And we were lucky that they didn't grab that rifle and shoot us. I was very happy because, you know, the stress you feel in your stomach, you feel your stomach very tight. So when I was at Brooks Army General Hospital here in San Antonio, and I saw my family, my wife, that's when finally it went away. I lost the use of my left arm quite a bit. And you know, you can see that how the muscles died on both sides of my hands. I wanted to become an AC technician. But I couldn't do it because my arm would not allow me to carry heavy stuff, and it was very sensitive. It would hurt a lot in the beginning. So I became a teacher. So I've been teaching over 35 years. I went to live in Mexico City for a few years, and I worked as a teacher 9 years. And then I came back to the United States, to Houston, and I've been teaching adults for so many years. And I feel good. I'm not a millionaire, but my satisfaction of helping other people to achieve, to be better in life, that has really, really helped. And I feel good. Life put me through a big experience, which is live a war. And that experience has made me a better person. After 39 years, I found these guys. All my friends from over there. 39 years without knowing where they were. So it was really the cherry on top in my life. we talk about our experiences, and it has helped us to heal. So it has been a blessing for me.